We have many different options for lathe automation, from robots, cobots, APLs, or bar feeders. But what if you just didn't have enough space for any of these? A typical bar feeder requires 7 feet or 2 meters of space on the left side of your lathe. We understand that here at Haas, and that's why we're offering a simple, cost-effective alternative that will allow semi-automated machining without taking any extra floor space. The Haas Bar Puller. Let's take a closer look at this tool and the VPS template that was created to complement this unit. We offer 3 types of shanks that will fit any of the Haas turrets. There are 1-inch or 25mm shank diameters, and there is also a VDI 40 option. The body is identical on all 3 types. There are master jaws that pivot from these pins. They are always in the closed position and open up to grip the material. Inside the body, there are heavy duty springs that provide a strong gripping force. The tension of this grip force can be changed by adjusting these set screws. The highest grip force can be achieved by adjusting the screws to around this position. Do not set the set screw below the nut's height. You will lose leverage. At this position, and with the least amount of friction, it is possible to pull around 130 pounds or 60 kilograms. That's a 4-inch steel bar about 3 feet long. The unit comes with 2 sets of jaws for large and small diameters. These jaws sit on the serrations of the master jaws. The small jaws can grip material as small as 6 millimeters, which is roughly 1/4 inch. They can be adjusted to grit diameters up to 60 millimeters, roughly around 2 1/4 inch diameter. The larger jaw set ranges from 54 millimeters to 110 millimeters, which is roughly around 2 1/8 inch diameter to 4 1/4 inch diameter. And it's not only capable of pulling round bars, the strong grip force can pull any square, rectangle, or hex stock. Let's set this tool up. We're here in front of the ST25Y. And look, we have no room for an APL or a bar feeder because this VF4 is in the way. This is perfect for our example. There's about 1 meter bar length that I can fit through the back of the spindle. And I just happen to have a bar that will fit perfectly. If I didn't have any access to the back end of the spindle, I could of course also load bars through the chuck side of the machine. If you have used a bar feeder before, you will know you don't just remove the union cover and load your bars. You are going to need a liner and a liner adapter. This also applies if you're using the Haas bar puller. I did mention earlier about pulling the bar with the least amount of friction. There's a great video by Matt Terryberry that's linked below. It explains why the liner can help reduce this friction. Let's head to Haas Tooling and pick the right adapter and liner. Click through to lathe work holding. Then select spindle liners. Select the drop down for compatibility. And using this chart, I can find my machine ST-25Y. It falls within this build date. If you have older machines, click here to find more options. So the adapter I need is 05-0206. And then I have the option of selecting the liner kit, 08-0199. Or just the 2.5-inch liner, 05-0190. If you do plan to bar pull a range of different diameter bars, then I recommend getting the kit. Here, we have the adapter and liner installed. The material is loaded, and our first part is machined and parted off. So we are ready to bar pull. Let's mount the bar puller into the turret. We're using the 1-inch shank 05-0584 puller. Simply load it into your BMT65 holder and clamp on the shank flat. Set the X geometry just like you would do a drill. I'm simply going to hit F3 on the tool geometry page for centerline. Now, before we set the D geometry, let's enter the VPS template. The bar puller VPS template can be found here by going back to the lathe work holding page where we were looking at the spindle liners. Enter the bar puller page. And select this drop down for the VPS templates. Follow the instructions provided here and then download the VPS templates directly from your Haas tooling website to your PC and then to your machine. After entering the basic data, work offset, the tool offset numbers, you need to enter the bar diameter. I will enter 2.5 inches here. The value changes the next template question because the 2.5 inches falls under the large jaw range. I'm instructed to mount the large jaws. There are also instructions as to what diameter I should set these jaws at. Typically, the jaws are around 80 to 120 thou smaller than your bar diameter, or 2 to 3 millimeters in metric. I can load my large jaws and set these to around 2.38 inches, along with making sure the serration positions match. I need a caliper to verify I'm as close to this range as possible. After a couple of adjustments, it's measuring 2.4 inches, which is close enough. It doesn't have to be that exact. The next line is instructing me to set the Z tool geometry from the tip of the closed jaw. You can touch this off a machine part before part off, or use the probe. I will set this off the probe like all my other tools were set. The next line is a display only row. Basically, letting the user know the puller will wrap it to center line after the Z rapid approach. So, the next line requires the distance from the datum to the cutoff point. It's typically the overall length of your part plus the cutoff insert width. I can do the calculation. My overall length is 1.5 inches and the cutoff insert is 118 thou wide. So I will enter 1.618 here. You could also just check your cutoff program and verify the Z distance. The next value required is the jaw grip length. The default value is recommended and will limit the depth to a value that is clear of the bottom of the face. The feeds used to approach and grip the bar are not slow. So the last thing you want to do is over travel this point and smack your tool against the face. More about that later. I'm going to leave this at the default value. The next value needed is the face-off amount for the next part in the cycle. This is the point the bar puller will position the cutoff face in front of the datum. I'm going to set this at 100 thou. After entering the retraction options, we are left with the final row, how we want to end this program. Usual options are offered, M00 stop, M01 optional stop, and M30 end of program. But typically on a bar feeder pull program, none of these are relevant. We need to loop the program to continue running the next part. So we have added the M99 option for program loop. Once I enter 99 here, another row is populated. How many parts do I want to yield from this bar before the program stops automatically? You can class bar pulling as unattended machining, just like bar feeding is, periodically returning to measure parts, check inserts, or load the next bar. That means you may not be around for the final part, so we really need to get this value correct. An overestimated value may machine the final part with the incorrect and unsafe work holding, causing major damage. I'm going to go through the steps to enter the correct value for my bar and program. First, The overall length of the bar is 36 inches. Next, I need to determine my minimum clamp length. What is the minimum length I could hold in these jaws for the final part? A quick measure, and I think 2 inches is safe. Anything less, it'll be too risky for safe work holding. I also need to determine how much material one part uses up. Just looking at my template, it's basically my Z cutoff length plus my face off amount, 1.718 inches. So, using the formula here, the result is 19.8. Typically, you would round this number down, so I will enter 19 here. There are also instructions to set the macros 10,000 and 10,001 to zero. These are the macros required for your parts count. So I'm going to press current commands, arrow over to the macro tab, and make sure those two macros are zero. Now I can press F4, and I'm going to insert this to the clipboard. Then, page down in my program to after my part off tool. And press F4 to insert the generated program here. There are a few basic notes based on my entered data. You'll also see notes on the program lines. This is handy because I'm going to verify a few positions before we run the cycle. First, I'm going to jog to centerline. Then the puller approach line, Z minus 1.54. That looks good and clear of the parted off face. Now I'm going to slowly jog in Z to the Z puller gripper point, Z minus 2.14. Make sure there is a gap between the bar face and the bottom of the jaw faces. Everything looks good, and the jaw grip surface clearly looks like it's fully engaged on the bar diameter. If there is an issue, you could change this Z minus 2.14 value. Just make sure that the bar pull to 0.1 in front of the datum value is adjusted the same amount to keep the next part of face amount constant. Now, let's run this. The puller jaws are made of alloy steel hardened to 40 Rockwell, tapered at the front to slide over the bar smoothly. The pull is good. I'll return periodically to fish out the completed parts. If all goes well, I'll reload the next bar in just over an hour. And if the next bar happens to be a different length, you can redo the number of parts calculation and enter new quantity as noted here on the program. Enjoy bar pulling automation on your lathe. My name is Bhop Singh. Thanks for watching.